Hello children, very good morning. Today we will discuss about strong and weak electrolytes. In the previous video, I told you all about the basic of chapter electrolysis. I told you all what is electrolysis, what is the meaning of conductor, what is metallic conductor and what is electrolytic conductor. Then after we discussed about electrolytes, we classified electrolytes into a strong electrolyte and weak electrolyte. So today we will discuss about a strong and weak electrolyte. So we will try to discuss with the help of comparative study of a strong and weak electrolyte. So let us do the comparative study. If we talk about strong electrolytes, it allow a large amount of electric current to pass through them. We all know electrolytes are the substance which passes electric current through them. But when we talk about a strong electrolyte passes large amount of electric current through them. Okay, so you can write it down. It passes large amount of electric current through them. Right? If we talk about weak electrolyte, just opposite of which, weak electrolytes allow a small amount of electric current to flow through them. Okay? So it allow a small amount of electric current. It allow a small amount of electric current to pass through them. Right? So first point we discussed, a strong electrolyte passes large amount of electric current to pass through them, while weak electrolyte passes a small amount of electric current to pass through them. Point number two, strong electrolytes are a very good conductor of electricity. Okay, so point number two, they are good conductors of electricity. While weak electrolytes are poor conductor of electricity. Since first point it was clear, a strong electrolyte passes large amount of electric current, it means they are good conductor. While if you talk about weak electrolyte, it passes a small amount of electric current, it means they are poor conductor of electricity. Point number third, if you talk about strong electrolytes, they are almost completely dissociates in fused or aqueous solution state. Okay, so they undergo complete dissociation. Okay, they undergo complete dissociation in aqueous solution or fused state. Okay, but weak electrolyte dissociate partially. Okay, they dissociate partially. Right. Point number four. The solution of strong electrolytes contain only free mobile ions. Point number four, solution of a strong electrolyte contains ओनली मोबाइल फ्री आयन. मोबाइल मीन्स मूविंग फ्री आयन, मोबाइल फ्री आयन्स, राइट. व्हाइल इफ वी टॉक अबाउट वीक इलेक्ट्रोलाइट, द सॉल्यूशन ऑफ वीक इलेक्ट्रोलाइट कंटेन्स आयन्स एज वेल एज मॉलिक्यूल्स, आयन्स एज वेल एज एज मॉलिक्यूल्स, मॉलिक्यूल्स. ओके, ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड इट, बिकॉज स्ट्रॉन्ग इलेक्ट्रोलाइट डिसोसिएट कंप्लीटली, दैट्स वाई ओनली आयन विल बी प्रेजेंट इन टू द सोल्यूशन ऑफ द स्ट्रॉन्ग इलेक्ट्रोलाइट, वाइल वीक इलेक्ट्रोलाइट डिसोसिएट पार्शियली. दैट्स वाई आयन अलॉन्ग विद मॉलिक्यूल विल बी प्रेजेंट इन टू द सोल्यूशन ऑफ वीक इलेक्ट्रोलाइट, राइट. पॉइंट नंबर फाइव, स्ट्रॉन्ग इलेक्ट्रोलाइट अलाउ a bulb to glow brightly, because only ions will be present, so flow of electricity will be very high. That's why bulb will glow brightly, while weak electrolyte allow a bulb to glow dimly. Means bulb will glow dimly into the weak electrolyte, while it will glow brightly into the strong electrolyte. Let us see some example of strong electrolyte. I have already told you all, electrolyte may be acid, base or salt. Okay, so we will see the example of strong electrolyte as acid. Strong electrolyte as acid include HCl, H2SO4, HNO3, etc. Base include NaOH, potassium hydroxide, KOH. Aqueous solution state or molten state, these bases will be in aqueous solution state or molten state, right. Now salt, we can see salt as a strong electrolyte. It includes molten sodium chloride, NaCl molten, lead bromide molten, CuCl2 in aqueous solution state, Aq, I'm writing here, they both will be into the molten state, molten, right. Copper sulfate into aqueous solution state, copper sulfate into aqueous solution state will be the example of a strong electrolyte. Now come at weak electrolyte. Weak electrolyte as acid, we can see carbonic acid means H2CO3, weak electrolyte. Acetic acid, CH3COOH, weak electrolyte. Oxalic acid, COOH whole twice, example of weak electrolyte, right. Now come weak acid as a base. It includes ammonium hydroxide, NH4OH, NS4OH, calcium hydroxide, CaOH whole twice, is the example of weak electrolyte. So weak electrolyte as a salt, we can see now, it includes ammonium carbonate, lead acetate, etc. Ammonium carbonate, NS4 whole twice, CO3, lead acetate means CH3COO whole twice PB, the example of weak electrolyte as a salt. Okay, so sometime it is asked in the examination, give the example of some strong and weak electrolyte, so accordingly you can give, right. I hope you people understood the difference between a strong and weak electrolytes, and separately as well what is a strong and weak electrolyte. Concept is clear now. Okay, see one more type of electrolyte that is called as non-electrolyte, not electrolyte. Okay, it is a non-electrolyte. So let us understand the concept of non-electrolyte. Non-electrolyte. What is non-electrolyte? It is a compound which neither in solution nor in the molten state allow an electric current to pass through them. Okay, how can you define it is a compound? It is a compound which neither in aqueous solution state or in molten state allows the electric current to pass through them. I hope you people understood. Again, you can see it is a compound which neither in aqueous solution state or in molten state allows the electric current to pass through them. Okay, so it means non-electrolyte do not have ions even in the solution. They do not have ions. They only contain molecule. Right? We have seen a strong electrolyte contains only ions only. We have seen weak electrolyte contains both ions as well as molecules, while non-electrolyte contains only molecule. Right? In your syllabus it is given. Define the type of a substance which contain only ions in the solution, both ion as well as molecule into the solution, and only molecule. So I hope you people understood. A strong electrolyte contains ions only. Weak electrolyte contains both ions as well as molecule. Non-electrolyte contains only molecule. Clear? Now we will discuss about electrolytic example of non-electrolytes. I hope you people know distilled water, alcohol. Some example of non-electrolyte I'm giving you all. Example of non-electrolyte: distilled water, alcohol, kerosene, CH2 carbon disulfide, cane sugar, benzene, glucose and urea. These are the example of non-electrolyte: distilled water, alcohol, kerosene, carbon disulfide, cane sugar, benzene, glucose and urea. Right? I hope you people understood. Now come at electrolytic cell or voltmeter. Next topic is electrolytic cell. It is also known as voltmeter. Right? So what is electrolytic cell? What is voltmeter? Voltmeter, it is a non-conducting vessel. Okay? So let us understand a definition. It is a non-conducting vessel. Conducting vessel containing two electrodes. It is a non-conducting vessel, means a container which do not conduct electric current. Okay, and it contains two electrode immersed in a solution. Containing two electrode immersed in a solution of electrolytes, okay, used to bring about a chemical reaction. Chemical reaction. Right? I hope you people understood the definition of electrolytic cell. What is electrolytic cell? As I have written here, it is a non-conducting vessel. Means it consists of a container which cannot conduct electric current. Apart from this, it contains two electrodes. Electrode I will tell after that. Okay? Which is immersed in a solution of electrolyte. That two electrodes are immersed, dipped into the solution of electrolyte, which is used to bring a chemical reaction. Right? This is called as electrolytic cell. With the help of diagram, I would like to represent electrolytic cell. Okay? So let us see with the help of diagram. This is a container or vessel, non-conducting vessel. It contains solution. You can represent solution here, right? Solution of electrolyte. Into this solution, two electrodes will be immersed. Okay, and they will be connected with the help of electric current. Right? And it is used to bring about a chemical reaction. Okay, these electrodes are cathode and anode. Electrolytic solution in short I'm writing, right? This is supply of electric current, here I'm representing, right? And this is a picture of electrolytic cell. I hope you people understood today's topic. Okay, in next video we will discuss about electrochemical cell in brief. What is electrode? Okay, what is the function of electrode? How can we understand anode and cathode? Then after we will try to understand cation and anion. Okay? So I hope you people are understanding the way we are discussing. Right? I have given you all project work. Some of you are asking, sir, it is very short. So please go back again and observe the topic whatever I have given you all. Okay? I hope you will be able to write in detail. Thank you so much.